Hi, hope you all are doing well. If not, do not lose hope. Have faith in your dreams. For a family patient, a known case, or someone back to a nursing home, how will you approach the writing task if it's such as a letter where the reader is familiar with the patient? The first thing that you have to consider is your introduction, which introduces the reason for writing. You can write an introduction which hints that the patient you refer is a known patient to the reader. Well, if that's the case, you should make sure that you avoid any relative clauses. Yes, relative clauses which describe the patient, especially the word who. Like, I'm writing to introduce Mr. Thompson, who recently underwent a right total hip replacement surgery. Mr. Thompson, who was diagnosed with type 2 diabetes. Mr. Thompson, who requires a psychiatric assessment. Such sentences or clauses with the relative pronoun who to tell diagnosis or complaint are not recommended. You have to inform about the diagnosis or complaint in a different manner, but not using a clause which describes the patient, because you do not need to describe a patient or client if he or she is known to the reader. Now, suppose the patient or the client is being sent again to the reader or sent back to the reader, or if the letter such as a referral letter to a family doctor. If this is what your writing task tells, then you can try something like this. Mr. Thompson is being discharged back into care, if it is a discharge letter. I am writing to update Ron's current health status, maybe for follow-up. I am writing to update you about current health status of Ron. Both ways, you have your own way of writing a sentence. Just make sure that you do not make any grammatical mistakes. I am writing in regard to your patient. Mrs. Thompson, a regular patient at your pharmacy, was admitted to hospital with something something. Mr. Thompson, who has a history of diabetes mellitus? No. Mr. Thompson, your patient who has a history of diabetes mellitus? Yes, this is correct. I'm writing to refer Mr. Smith back into care. No. That is not correct, as you cannot use the word refer if the reader already knows the patient. Also, remember, a known case of yours, it's not a common phrase that is used in English. Perfect. I believe the things are clear to you. Suppose in the writing task, you read, write a letter to a local GP. This does not necessarily mean that the GP knows the patient. On the other hand, if in the writing task, they give like, write a letter to the patient's GP. This indicates the patient is known to the reader. So in short, what I'm trying to say is, read your writing task, your case note properly, and then plan how your letter has to be. And yes, avoid medical history and social background. Focus on the purpose of the letter, and write information required for the reader. Yes, you will be writing information like about recent emergency events, nursing management, condition after an operation, current condition, and the request recommendation part. About the post-discharge care, things to note, right. You can also use expressions like, as you know, as you are probably aware, in order to remind the reader about any event from patient's medical history or social background, or while connecting any relevant case note, right. In the same way, if the letter is to a parent, maybe informing his or her child's health progress, or you being a school nurse, informing the parent about your student's concerns. Like we discussed for a familiar health professional, here also we avoid medical social background, and we concentrate on the recent events, things to note or monitor, future appointments, recommendations, suggestions. Right. Hey, it's time for a small practice. You have 60 seconds. Read this case note and transform them into a sentence. Comment your sentences in the comment box. Time's up. Here is my sentence. He presented with a 1 week history of chest pain that occurs on exertion. The pain associated with dyspnea radiates towards the left arm and is relieved by rest. Next. Time's up. Here is my sentence. She presented with a progressively enlarging lump since 6 months. The lump is pain-free, hard, and mobile, measuring 5 cm in diameter. No palpable nodes were noticed in the axillary area.
Thank you.